尊敬的麦卡锡总裁，尊敬的吴建民先生，女士们、先生们、朋友们，大家晚上好。
Distinguished President McCarthy, distinguished Mr. Dominic Nguyen, ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, good evening.
在这样一个美好的夜晚，很高兴和大家共聚一堂。首先，对麦卡锡总裁的真诚邀请和朋友们的热情的欢迎，表示衷心的感谢。对洛杉矶世界事务委员会在关注国际事务、推进国际交流等方面的努力和贡献，表示由衷的赞赏。
It's my great pleasure to join all of you in this beautiful evening. First of all, I would like to extend my sincere thanks to President McCarthy for your kind invitation and to all our friends here for your warm welcome. I must commend the Los Angeles World Affairs Council for your great work and contributions in the field of international affairs and the promotion of international exchange.
中国古诗讲，相知无远近，万里尚为邻。中美两国虽然远隔万里，但两国人民相互了解、相互学习的心意是相通的，向往和平、追求幸福的愿望是一致的。改革开放以来，中国与美国在政治、经济、人文、科技、生态环境等各个领域的相互交流与战略合作日益深入，为世界和平和发展做出了积极的贡献。但是今天，作为中国的文化部长，我更愿意就文化的主题与各位进行交流。
As the ancient Chinese poem goes, near or far, true friends are always good neighbors. The geographical distance between China and the United States has never kept our people far from each other. Our people share the same wish to know and learn from each other and share the same aspirations for peace and happiness. Since China's reform and opening up, our two countries have witnessed ever-deepening exchange and strategic cooperation in many fields, including politics, economy, culture, education, science, technology, and environment, and people-to-people exchange, which has positively contributed to world peace and development. Today, as China's cultural minister, I would like to share some ideas with you on the theme of culture.
文化如水，润物无声。它是一个国家和民族赖以生存发展的精神家园，也是一个民族区别于其他民族的显著的标志。美国的诗人惠特曼有一句诗句：哪里有土，哪里有水，哪里就长着青草。中国也有一句俗语叫做一方水土养一方人，说的都是同样一个道理。美国是一个移民国家，在历史的发展中形成了多元包容创新的文化特色。美国精神为文化的繁荣、社会的进步提供了丰厚的精神土壤，而我们中华民族历经五千多年的历史变革，形成了讲仁爱、重民本、守诚信、崇正义、上和和、求大同的价值理念，以及群则变、变则通、通则久的哲学思想，在海纳百川、兼容并蓄中创造了灿烂辉煌的历史文化，为中华民族生生不息提供了丰厚的滋养。
Culture is like water that nurtures the world in a gentle and quiet way. It forms the spiritual homeland on which nations and communities thrive and shapes the identities of different people. The American poet Walt Whitman once wrote, "This is the grass that grows wherever the land is and the water is."And the Chinese proverb also says, as water and soil differ, so do people. There seems to be a parallel between these two lines. The United States is a country of immigrants. While making many progresses in history, it has developed a special culture marked by diversity, inclusiveness, and innovation. And the American spirit has become a fertile land from which the American culture and society grew and prospered.The Chinese nation, through a history of over 5,000 years, has accumulated a series of core values featuring compassion, humanism, integrity, fairness, harmony, and cohesion. It has also embraced a philosophy of dynamic change and organic metabolism, which encourages people to seek solutions by constant reform and renewal. The Chinese culture, by its nature, is open and inclusive. It has thus absorbed numerous diversified elements through the ages and produced a splendid civilization in history, providing vitality to the Chinese people for generations.
今天我们在继承优秀的传统文化、借鉴世界优秀文明成果的基础上，在国家层面，我们倡导富强、民主、文明、和谐；在社会层面，我们倡导自由、平等、公正、法治；在公民个人层面，我们倡导爱国、敬业、诚信、友善，着力构建当代中国新的文化价值理念，激发人们的创造活力，推动中国社会的进步与发展。
Today, we are not only keen on inheriting our good traditions, but also eager to draw from the cultural achievements across the world. On the government level of China, we advocate the building of a rich, strong, democratic, richly cultured, and harmonious country. On the public level, we seek to build a society of freedom, equality, fairness, and rule of law.And on the individual level, we advocate the value of patriotism, professionalism, credibility, and kindness. By promoting these new cultural values of contemporary China, we hope to bring out the great creativity and vitality of our people, and enhance the development and progress of our society.
一段时间以来，在中国传播最广、获得响应最热烈的词是“中国梦”，这就是习近平主席提出的。全面建成小康社会，初步实现中国的现代化，进而实现中华民族的伟大复兴，这是全体中国人的一个伟大的愿景，一个中国梦。我们知道，要实现这个梦想，不仅需要经济发展、政治清明、社会稳定、人民团结、山川秀美，更需要文化的繁荣。没有文化的繁荣发展，就没有中国的现代化。这并不只是我作为文化部长的一厢情愿，而是全体中国人的共同的理念。可以说，今天中国的文化建设承载着极为重要的使命。我们要构建把全体中国人凝聚在一起而共同团结奋斗的核心价值，要传承和弘扬中华民族博大精深、源远流长的优秀传统文化，要发展文化事业。以满足人民日益增长的精神文化需求，要以开放包容的博大胸怀，同世界各国各民族进行文化的交流互鉴，国家的富强、民族的振兴，要以文化的繁盛为支撑。
Nowadays, there is one term which has spread most extensively in China and gained great public response. This is the Chinese Dream.This term, proposed by President Xi Jinping, summarizes the great vision of the Chinese people for a well-off and modern society and for the great renewal of our nation. In China, we have a consensus that the Chinese dream includes not only the prospects of economic growth, good governance, social stability, public solidarity, good environment, but also cultural prosperity.Without cultural development and prosperity, one can never build a modern society with success. This is not a personal dream of myself as China's cultural minister, but a shared dream of all the Chinese people. Therefore, this is also a great mission for all cultural professionals in China. To fulfill this mission, we have pledged to foster a new set of core values that can empower the Chinese people in their cohesive efforts towards our shared aspirations.And we will go deeper into our rich and time-honored traditional cultures, inherit and promote our most valuable assets, build a strong public cultural service network so as to meet the increasing demands of our people for culture, and we shall engage in extensive cultural exchange and mutual learning with all nations of the world with a broad mind and an open heart.In one word, we shall tap the rich source of culture in China to fuel the great renewal of our nation and meet the common interest of all our people.
女士们、先生们、朋友们，随着全球化进程的不断深入，跨国家、跨地区、跨文化交流的意义正在凸显。世界需要开放的中国，中国也需要向世界开放。历史告诉我们，不同的文化只有相互交流、相互借鉴，才能充满着生机与活力。中国与世界文化的交流源远流长，早在15世纪 郑和率领的中国船队七次远行到西太平洋和印度洋，拜访了30多个国家和地区，最远曾经到达过非洲的东部。中国的造纸、火药、印刷术、指南针等四大发明曾推动了世界文明的进步。中国的哲学思想、文学作品也曾经为增添世界文化的丰富性做出了重要的贡献。同样，中国的音乐、美术、文学也深受世界文化艺术的影响，无论是横贯欧亚大陆的古丝绸之路，还是连接太平洋、印度洋、地中海的海上丝绸之路，都不仅仅是东西方贸易的大通道，更是东西方文明交流的大通道。中国有一句名言叫做各美其美，美人之美，美美与共，天下大同，说的就是要承认文化的多样性、平等性、包容性，在多样中求同一，在交流中求共识，彼此尊重，求同存异，取长补短，相互促进。中国将继续本着相互尊重、合作共赢的原则，不断扩大和深化对外文化的开放，把中国文化带到世界的各个角落，把世界各国的优秀文化介绍到中国，增进中国人民对于世界各国人民之间的彼此了解，以及中国和世界各国之间的友好合作。
Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, as our world enters into a new age of globalization, cultural exchange across nations, regions, and traditions have also gained more prominence. The world needs an open China, and China needs to open to the world.History has taught us that different cultures can maintain vitality and vibrancy only through mutual exchange and mutual learning. And China is never a stranger to cultural exchange since time old. As early as the 15th century, the Chinese navigator Zheng He had led his fleet on 7 long-distance voyages to West Pacific and the Indian Ocean, visiting over 30 nations and regions as far as East Africa.The four great inventions of ancient China, namely paper, explosive powder, printing, and compass, have helped to propel the progress of human civilization. Chinese philosophy and Chinese literature have greatly enriched the world culture. At the same time, China has also assimilated the influences of world cultures in many areas, such as music, arts, and literature.The ancient Silk Road across the Eurasian continent and the maritime Silk Road linking the Pacific Ocean, the Indian Ocean, and the Mediterranean Sea have served not only as trade routes connecting the East with the West, but also open gateways along which different cultures crossbred and blended. As a famous Chinese sociologist puts it, when people learn to appreciate the beauty of their own culture as well as that of others, the world will achieve great harmony and peace.Such is the ideal of the Chinese people for cultural diversity, equality, and cohesion. We shall always seek commonality in diversity, build consensus through communication, respect each other, share common visions, complement and help each other while appreciating our differences. China will continue to honor the principle of mutual respect and win-win cooperation, continuously pursue cultural openness,Share the Chinese culture with people of the world while continuing to introduce to our people cultures from other countries. By doing this, we believe it will enhance the mutual understanding between our peoples and strengthen the friendly relations between our nations.
中美两国虽然存在着巨大的差异，但两国的文化交流并不缺乏精彩动人的篇章，正在呈现出迅速发展的良好势头。近年来，我们两国政府在中美人文交流高层磋商机制及中美文化交流协定的框架下，积极地推动激励两国的文化机构开展相互间开展机制性的合作，签署了一系列促进长期合作的协议和谅解备忘录，开展了影响广泛和富有成效的文化交流。包括在思想文化领域，我们两国已经举办了第三届中美文化论坛，包括美国国会图书馆馆长比林顿先生、前人文基金会主席利奇先生、中国前文化部长文学家王蒙先生、中国诺贝尔文学奖获得者莫言等都参与了论坛。在北京的天坛公园曾经留下了比林顿先生随着晨练音乐翩然幡然起舞的身影，在上海博物馆的地下花园，中美的观众聆听了两国诗人饱含激情的诗歌朗诵。
Admittedly, China and the United States have quite many differences, but our cultural exchange has never been short of exciting highlights and is going on an upward track very fast. In recent years in particular, the Chinese and U.S. governments have actively encouraged the institutional collaboration between Chinese and American cultural institutions under the framework of China-U.S. High-Level Consultation on People-to-People Exchange and the China-U.S. Cultural Agreement. We have signed a series of agreements and MOUs for long-term cooperation and initiated many influential and fruitful cultural exchange programs. In the field of intellectual exchange, for example, our two sides have jointly hosted three sessions of China-U.S. Cultural Forum, involving such dignitary speakers as Mr. James Billington, Librarian of Congress, Mr. James Leach, former Chairman of the National Endowment for Humanities, Mr. Wang Meng, Chinese writer and former Minister of Culture, and Nobel Literary Laureate Mo Yan. In the Temple of Heaven of China, we have had the experience of seeing Mr. Billington dancing spontaneously to the music of local Chinese during their morning exercises. And in the underground park of Shanghai Museum, passionate readings of poetry from China and the United States by the poets of our of two sides enthralled audiences for all of us.
2011年，文化部和肯尼迪表演中心、表演艺术中心联合举办了为期一个月的中国一个国家的艺术系列活动。今年五月，印第安纳波利斯儿童博物馆揭开了为期三年的“带我去中国”大型综合文化展示活动。前两天，我在华盛顿参加了中国文化部和史密森学会联合举办的史密森民俗节中国主题活动，100多位中国的民俗艺术家表演了精湛的民间艺术，与美国的民众展开了一次有关传统与生活艺术的亲密接触。在不久的将来，美国杰斐逊基金会将与中国国家图书馆合作，在北京等地举办大型的杰斐逊展，相信它将为中国观众了解美国的历史和文化打开又一扇窗口。
Among so many very active and dynamic cultural programs between China and the United States, I would like to name a few. In 2011, the Ministry of Culture of China and the Kennedy Center for the Performing Arts collaborated in a month-long event named China, the Art of a Nation. Actually, the minister didn't read that Chinese part because he wanted me to just speak in English to save time. I will say talk about some of the anecdotes. This program has a highlight named The Red Detachment of Women. It's a ballet from China, and it was highly lauded. So all the friends of our minister still talked about it today. And in May this year, a three-year cultural event named Take Me There, China series was launched by the Children's Museum of Indianapolis, which, okay, in this program, little children could wear Chinese qipao, eat Chinese jiaozi, and visit the Great Wall and see the giant panda on mini planes. And just 2 days ago, Minister attended the 2014 Smithsonian Folklife Festival featuring China. And in this program, the Ministry of Culture of China and the Smithsonian Institution jointly brought over 100 Chinese folk artists and artisans to the National Mall to share their refined artmanship with the audiences. And at the same time, this program is also themed on tradition and the art of living, something that the Chinese have learned for thousands of years and now sharing with the American people. Not long ago, the Philadelphia Orchestra visited China and they had a pop-up performance on a delayed flight from Beijing to Macau. And that became a headline in China. Everybody was talking about that. In the near future, we will also receive in China a large exhibition on President Jefferson under the collaboration of the Thomas Jefferson Foundation and the National Library of China, which will open another window on American history and culture for the Chinese public.
目前以中美两国政府支持为基础，文化机构和企业为主体，民间团体广泛参与的机制正在呈现一个良好的发展态势。去年十月，在恒廷顿图书馆，我们共同举办了旨在推动两国文化艺术及文化企业合作的跨越太平洋中美文化产业对话。 美国梦工厂动画公司与上海东方传媒有限公司等联合成立东方梦工厂动画公司，美国迪士尼公司在上海新建了主题乐园，美国的流行音乐在中国的商业市场深受年轻人的喜欢，中国对外文化集团与美国国际管理艺术集团联合在纽约成立了中美环球演艺股份有限公司，大型熏猫秀进驻了拉斯维加斯。我们相信这些合作必将为中美文化企业合作与发展带来更多的机遇。
As we speak, many more very exciting moments are going to happen between China and the U.S. on the cultural front. With more governmental support in place, more and more Chinese and American cultural institutions, enterprises, and social organizations and individuals are now engaged in closer collaboration with each other. In last October, for instance, a dialogue under the title Culture and Commerce Across the Pacific, a China-U.S. dialogue, was jointly hosted by the Ministry of Culture of China and the Huntington Library, which is set to promote direct cooperation between Chinese-American cultural and artistic enterprises and professionals. In the business sector, as we have distinguished guests here, the American company DreamWorks Animation and Shanghai Media Group jointly established the Oriental DreamWorks. The Walt Disney Company built a Disneyland in Shanghai. American pop music enjoys great popularity among Chinese young people. China Arts and Entertainment Group and IMG Artists jointly established Sino-America Global Entertainment.And Panda, a great show, is now making its way to Las Vegas. And you also mentioned the performances in the great Super Bowl. Such collaborations, we believe, will bring more opportunities for Chinese and American cultural enterprises and individuals together and lead them to a more successful cooperation in the future.
女士们、先生们、朋友们，去年六月，习近平主席和奥巴马总统在安娜伯格庄园会晤期间表示，中美将共同努力构建新型的大国关系。习近平主席将新型大国关系的内涵概括为三句话：一是不冲突、不对抗；二是相互尊重；三是合作共赢。我相信，在中美两国人民的共同努力下，日益频繁深入的文化交流一定能够为构建中美两国新型大国关系打下更加坚实的人文基础。最后，衷心的祝愿中美两国人民幸福安康，期待着中美两国的文化交流绽放出新的更加灿烂的花朵。谢谢大家。
Ladies and gentlemen, dear friends, in June last year, Chinese President Xi Jinping and American President Barack Obama had a historic meeting in Annenberg Retreat.They have put forward a vision that China and the United States shall join hands in building a new model of major country relationship. In the words of President Xi, such a relationship means three things. One, no conflict and no confrontation. Two, mutual respect, including for each other's core interests and major concerns. And three, win-win cooperation. I believe this vision will be realized with the joint efforts of the Chinese and American people.I believe China-U.S. cultural exchange will be more frequent and dynamic. And with culture, we will lay a more solid public foundation for such a desirable vision. Last but not least, I wish both the Chinese and American people enjoy great happiness and well-being, and I wish China-U.S. cultural exchange blossom with more beautiful flowers. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Thank you. Again.
We have time for some questions. We have a microphone here. If you can put your hand up and we'll get the microphone to you. It's not rocket science. There's one over here.
蔡部长您好，我是环球东方卫视的记者李英。那么首先呢，是非常这个欢迎您再次来到洛杉矶啊。我知道您对洛杉矶已经是不是说很陌生了，那么我知道这一次您来美国那个做访问呢，主要是有一个很重要的原因，就是要续签 这个中美两国这个政府文化交流这个协定2014到2016的这个执行策划书。那么我想问一下，您能不能就是稍微就是解释一下这个策划书大概具体是什么内容？谢谢。
根据这些年我们和中美双方开展文化交流的这个经验，我们觉得应该把它逐步的纳入啊规范的轨道。他刚才
I'm from Global Oriental, Li Yan. I'm asking that I've learned that the Ministry of Culture is going to renew, is implementing a Accord of Cultural Cooperation between China and the United States government through the years 2014 and 2016.We wonder what that means to us. Minister says, we have always been working hard to try to make the cultural exchange between China and the United States more sustainable on an institutional basis.
下个月中美双方将在战略磋商机制包括人文交流机制的磋商将在中国举行。我这次的访问也是为这次磋商做准备。在华盛顿，我和美国艺术基金会、人文基金会、美国图书馆联盟以及艺术联盟等文化机构和团体负责人进行了深入的交流。我们初步规划了未来几年我们之间交流的一些总的指导方针和一些大的方向。
In this July, China and the U.S. will have another round of strategic dialogue, including the people-to-people consultation. My visit this time is just a preparation for that very important dialogue. Therefore, in Washington, D.C., the last stop I have made in this American trip, I met with the leaders of the National Endowment of Arts, National Endowment of Humanities, the IMLS, and the very important institutional leaders. And we had very in-depth exchange of views, and we have mapped out our future for many cultural initiatives.
我们将不断地扩大我们在文化交流领域里的各个方面，不断地扩大这些领域。
We will further expand the scope of cultural exchange and cooperation between China and the United States.
我们不但鼓励官方之间的交流，我们更注重民间的交流。
We will attach importance not only to government-supported programs, but also programs initiated on the private level and organizational level and individual levels.
我们不仅仅发展我们在公共文化事业领域的交流与合作，我们也要加速发展我们在文化企业领域、文化产业领域的交流与合作。
We also speed up cooperation not only on the public cultural and arts exchange programs, but also on the cultural enterprises and cultural and creative industries.
我们将大力推动中美文化产品和文化服务的贸易。
We will further promote the trade of cultural products and services between China and the United States.
中国的文化市场也将会更大的一些对外开放。
The cultural market of China will be more open to the United States.
当然，我们同时也将更加加强在知识产权保护和维护自由贸易规则等方面的一些努力，做更多的努力。
At the same time, we will also step up our efforts in safeguarding intellectual property rights during this process, and also to safeguard the order of international cultural trade.
我认为中美之间的文化交流潜力巨大，前景光明。只要我们双方共同努力，一定会取得更加丰硕的成果。
I believe that the future of cultural exchange and cooperation between China and the United States has great potentials and very bright prospects, so long as we join our efforts together.
你好，谢谢你来这里，这个网上。我要试一试问你我的用我的中文问你好不好？我叫施百丽，我是洛杉矶人。你最近在美国和世界旅行以后，你认为什么西方文化中国人应该学习？I'll use my English too. So, sorry, I know my Chinese isn't the best, but I wanted to try.
Chinese is so good. Oh, God, that was so good. Great try.
So after his recent travels here in the U.S. and around the world, because I know he's, you know, been doing his diplomatic stuff, what cultural traditions and aspects from, you know, the U.S. and the Western cultures does he think the Chinese people should learn and absorb to, like, what cultural traditions should change?
您已经在世界上很多国家都访问过，而且也在美国来过很多地方。请问您觉得美国和西方文化有哪些是中国可以学习的？
全世界文化的多样性是它的一个基本的特征。那么这些多样性的特征表现在每一个文化都有自己的优长，所以应该在平等的基础上，在相互尊重的基础上，相互借鉴、相互学习，有时互补，共同发展。
Indeed, our world is a world of cultural diversity. Therefore, the principle of cultural exchange should be exchange on an equal basis and mutual respect and mutual learning. We have a lot to learn from each other.
美国文化中间呢，有几个特点是非常鲜明的，非常值得我们借鉴。第一个是它的多样性。 美国的文化，美国是一个移民国家，它的文化是多元的。这种多样性的文化是，也正好是世界文化的一个缩影。
Indeed, the American culture has a lot to offer to us. For example, diversity. We know the United States is a country of immigrants, therefore there is a lot of richness and diversity in your culture. I think this is just as the basic fundamental feature of the world culture. Diversity is something we treasure and respect.
第二个令人非常印象深刻的是美国的创新精神。美国无论在科学技术领域还是在文化创意领域，它总是层出不穷的创新创意，非常值得我们借鉴。And
secondly, very importantly, innovation is a very important part of the American culture. This has been very visible in the field of science and technology and also culture and creative industries. It seems that the American people have never stopped innovation on any front. So this is something we should learn from.
那么在文化产业领域来讲，中国有着非常丰富的文化资源，有着非常深厚的文化传统。我们有着广阔的文化市场，我们有着世界上最大的文化消费人群，而美国有着先进的技术，有着非常创新的这种创意，有着丰富的管理经验，在这些方面，我们完全可以交流、合作、互利共赢。
In the field of cultural industries, China has a lot of cultural resources. We have a very long tradition of culture loving among our people and a lot of cultural traditions. We also have a big cultural market for the world and maybe the biggest population of cultural consumers in China. At the same time, the United States has very advanced technology in the cultural field, a lot of innovative ideas, and great experience in management. So when these things come together, we can work magic.
我们在这儿有个非常生动的例子，我的好朋友科森伯克先生在这儿，熏猫本来是中国的国宝，功夫本来是中国的传统，他把熏猫功夫结合起来，用美国的高新技术把它制作成功夫熏猫，现在又去到中国的市场去。
I think a very good example comes from Mr. Kazenberg, my good friend. We all know that Kung Fu comes from China, the panda comes from China, but Kung Fu Panda, as a high-tech product produced by very innovative minds from Mr. Kazenberg and his colleagues, have come to the Chinese market.
所以这就是很好的例子，说明我们两国在各个领域里头，经济领域、文化领域里头，我们是优势互补的，是完全可以在平等合作的基础上。
I think this is a very telling example as for how China and the United States can come together in economic and cultural fields through complementing, through mutual enrichment, equal-based cooperation, and win-win cooperation.
3年以前，我访问洛杉矶的时候，向卡森伯格先生建议，他到中国的上海去和中方进行合作，他接受了我的建议。 3年以后，刚才我问他对这个合作怎么样，他说非常满意。
I personally feel very proud that 3 years ago, I may take some credit from that, I suggested to Mr. Kazembrek to start a joint venture with someone in Shanghai. And now today I asked him 3 years later what happened, and he said everything goes on just smoothly, and I'm very happy to learn that.
今年迪士尼的总裁先生也在场。我当年在研究迪士尼在上海开办迪士尼乐园的时候，我提了一个建议，我说希望在中国建设的迪士尼乐园应该有更多的中国文化的因素。总裁先生告诉我说，他们已经充分地考虑了这个因素，并且在设计中间已经在贯彻这个。
And Mr. Bird, from Vice President from Disneyland, is also present. A few years ago, I also talked with them about the establishment of the Disney park in China. And my suggestion is that if you are building a park in China, try to incorporate the Chinese cultural elements here. And they have taken my advice, and now this is going to be a park with very interesting Chinese flavors.
刚才我讲了，任何一种文化，只有它在开放、包容、交流、互鉴中间，才能永葆它的活力和生命力。
So just as I have said in my speech just now, all cultures should retain their vitality and sustainability only through openness, inclusiveness, exchange with other cultures, and mutual learning.
那说完。
Mr. Minister, back here. In today's China, can an artistic effort or artistic impulse be a truly personal expression, or does it necessarily have to respond to some broader, what you described as a common interest or a China dream?
Is that a question or statement? I mean, I'm sorry. I didn't catch the first part.
In today's China,
yep.
Does an artistic impulse, can it be truly personal, or is it responding, or does it necessarily have to respond to a more broadly public or even a political interest?
I got it. 就是在今天的中国，我想问一下，艺术家的创作到底是基于个人表达的需求呢，还是必须要回应某种政治的需要，或者说必须要反映这个中国的一些这个社会的要求？
他一个真正的艺术家，他当然是可以自由地发挥他的艺术个性，但是他的真正的艺术的创作的源泉是社会，是生活，是人民群众的心声。如果一个艺术家只是在孤芳自赏中间来创造他的艺术，那么这种艺术的价值是值得怀疑的。
In my opinion, every artist has the right to express their own characters, their own mind, and their own individuality. But every artist also lives in a living society. Therefore, he or she has to have something to do with the overall life of this country. And it is better that this artist can also feel with the people to echo the realities of people's mind and heart and spirit. So I think that kind of art is, I'm sorry, I rephrase that. I think artists will have higher values when they think not only for themselves, but also for the whole society, acting as conduit for the people.
作为文化部长，我一直鼓励和提倡我们的艺术家们，他们两句话。第一句话，他们的创作要以人民为中心。第二句话说，就是要百花齐放，百家争鸣。你有多大的艺术才能，希望你自由的驰骋，希望你尽情的发挥。
As the cultural minister of China, if I can have two words for two advices for Chinese artists. The first is, I hope they can create their arts based on their compassion for the people. And second, I hope that they can make the best of their talent and create diversified and rich arts according to themselves so that China can enjoy cultural prosperity in the spirit of let 100 flowers blossom and 100 schools of thought content.
为了人民， 依靠人民，由人民来享有文化艺术的成果。
In terms of culture, all cultural products or creative forms of art shall be created for the people. It shall be shared by our people, and it shall benefit our people.
Thank you.